Hi, it's Andy.
As you can see, I got the plough on. It's Saturday morning. I'm gonna go and start a bit of ploughing. Yeah, it's like oat stubble, but I'm gonna be ploughing in. We've got quite a few grass beads in it, so we're just going to plough it in and hope that gets rid of most of them. So I've got it's obviously a Cavernaland plough. I think it's RG100, the model. It's 6-furrow reversible, semi-mounted. Yeah, so we're just going to see what we can do. I think I've got about, there must be, best part of 100 acres to do. Yeah, best part of 100 acres to plough. Do a bit each year. Most of our ground is mint hill, so we just, as soon as we've combined it, go run over it with the discs to get a chip on all the volunteers and grass weeds. And then when we want getting close to drilling, we spray it off with glyphosate, cultivate it. With our Valestad top down, and then I'll drill it. But yeah, I expect I shall plough this up over the next few days, cultivate it, and then drill it. Get it drilled before it gets wet. Adjustments to make on the plough. It's a bit to end up. Notice sort of some of the skimmers have adjusted themselves. They're all at different depths. So yeah, we'll get it all set up and see if we can make a nice job of it. At least the ground isn't like concrete like last year. Headland. So we'll just borrow it. That's our front furrow. I'll try that about there. Quite a big headland. Terminus plough. What I normally do is find the tyre mark from the third time round with the pop iron. Is that a bit big? About there. Don't count for my little feet. Right, we'll drop that down. Make a little mark. I don't know. I'm following one of the tyre marks from the combine when I went the third time around the headland. I've dropped the rear furrow down. Right, back again. The battery fell out of the camera. Right, I'm just going to adjust some of these skimmers. Because they're all different measurements, and then we'll give it a try. Right, I made a few adjustments to the plough. Just set out an AB line with the GPS. So let's see if we can do a bit of ploughing. So much easier if I haven't got to worry about the steering. I can concentrate on what the plough's doing. Ploughing. Looks like we're going in nice and deep. about GPS. I wouldn't be about it. Only got that front in a tiny bit as we're striking out. The back's right in. It looks like it's doing a really good job. About to go for a tram line, so that'd be interesting. See how hard the tram lines are this year. Seems to be going through that time. Right, let's see if we can also track our way back again, shall we? We've run our front tyre right about there. What happens? There we go, that's our strikeout. We're cracking on with it now. Got it set up quite nicely. Go. I know I'll make a nice job of that now. Nice big 6 metre power harrow. I'd firm it up nicely for the drill. Our drill likes a firm seedbed. And the old cultivator, what we got, don't really leave it firm enough. Yeah, so there we go. That's my ploughing. I'll stick the camera to the plough and see what it looks like from down there. Walk his dog when he's plowing. Come, buddy. I don't know why he's running on the dirt. I'm an idiot. Eric, get out of it. Go on. Come on. Come on, then. God knows why he's running on the dirt. What an idiot. Right, I've nearly finished the build. Yeah, just on. We've got one more time to do around the headland. My neck's gone a bit stiff. Yeah, we've had a couple of rain showers, but it hasn't wetted it too much. Still getting along fine. That's a good job. I'm quite pleased with it, to be honest. Plow's a bit clumsy in the corners. It's a bit annoying really. You gotta sort of steer it. I think I'd prefer a mounted one to be honest. Six furrow fully mounted. Be a lot quicker. That seems to have plenty of power for the plow anyway. All week I've had a neck ache from looking out the left hedge cutting. Now I've got a neck ache from looking out the back right at the plow. Yeah, so it's done pretty well. Pretty chuffed. I guess I'll probably leave it at that.